Welcome back to your free training course for Windows 7. So far, we have looked at upgrading to Windows 7 and performing a clean install of Windows 7 using a number of different methods. These methods work well when you only have a few computers to install Windows 7 on, but what do you do when you have hundreds or even thousands of computers on which you need to install Windows 7? Even if you have only performed a few installs of Windows 7, you will start to notice that you are selecting the same selections in the setup to the same questions. Microsoft has created the Windows Setup Information Manager, which is software to help you automate and customize your Windows 7 installs. This is included in the Windows Automated Installation Kit. Windows Setup Information Manager allows you to create an answer file for questions asked during the setup. An answer file provides answers to the questions asked by the setup. This means that you can automate the setup so no user interaction is required. The answer file gives answers to the simple questions like which language and keyboard to use. The answer file can accept the license screen and answer more complex questions like how to format the hard disk. The answer file can also provide answers to questions not asked during the setup. Microsoft has streamlined the setup process, and thus there are not many customization settings. Having said this, you may want to add additional features to your install or remove certain features before you even add any third-party software to your computer. One common example used in business is that you may want to remove the games from Windows. The setup does not give you the option to do this, but with an answer file, you can tell setup not to install any games. The file is in XML format, and thus you can create and edit it in Notepad. However, it's best to use the tools supplied by Microsoft. Once you have created the answer file, it can be placed in the root folder of a USB thumb drive, added to the root folder of the DVD, or if the setup is run from the command prompt, the answer file can be added with the command line switch unattend. To create an answer file, I will change to my Windows 7 computer. First, I need to install Windows Aik on my computer. This is available for download from Microsoft as an ISO image. Once you have burnt the image to a DVD, insert the DVD and the auto run will run. From the menu screen, select Windows Aik Setup to launch the setup. The setup is a simple one. Just accept the license screen, choose the path, and next your way to the end of the install. You will notice that I am installing this on Windows 7. However, I could have installed on Windows Vista or even Windows XP. The choice of operating system used to create the answer file is irrelevant when creating the answer file. Once installed, the next step is to insert my Windows 7 DVD, browse to the directory Sources, and then in the Sources directory, locate the file install.wim. This file then needs to be copied to the local computer. This file contains all the source files for your Windows 7 install. You need to make a copy on the local computer because Windows System Image Manager needs to create a catalog file. For this file to be created, it needs to be able to write to the location where the install.wim is stored. On this computer, it took about 10 minutes to create the catalog file. Once created, I can now create an answer file. In the computer world, it is often best not to reinvent the wheel. Instead of creating an answer file from scratch, I will select the option Open Answer File and then browse to the Windows Aik directory under Program Files. In this directory, there is a sample directory which contains a number of answer files already configured. Once I select one of these, I will get a message asking if I want this answer file to be associated with the Home Premium image. The Home Premium image is the image that I opened earlier. I will use this answer file with that image, so I will select Yes. You will notice that I have a number of different sections. These are called passes. The first pass is called Windows PE. When you boot off the DVD to install Windows 7, this will launch Windows PE, and Windows PE will launch the setup. Settings in this pass will identify the Windows image from which the install will be done. Also, you can configure the Windows PE operating system, such as the firewall configuration that will be used by Windows PE. The next pass is offline servicing. Before your install of Windows 7 begins, you can add additional drivers and updates to the image in this pass. The next pass is Generalise. Every install of Windows has security IDs. These IDs are used to identify the installation of Windows and forms the foundation of security on the local computer. This pass is required to ensure that when duplicating different computers on the network, that their security settings are different. The next pass is Specialize. This is the pass that you are most likely to add settings to. In this pass, you can configure things such as the hard disk to which you're going to install and configure options such as the network. The next pass, Audit System, is run just before the user gets the chance to log on. This is done to add final customization to the image. This pass is only run when deploying computers where the system is configured to boot into this mode. Later on in this course, you will learn how to do this. The Audit User Pass is run after the user logs in. Like the Audit System Pass, this pass will only run when configured to do so. The last pass is OOBE System, or Out of the Box Experience. This pass is run before the Windows Welcome starts. If you have ever purchased a new computer, the computer is most likely to have been configured to start up with the Out of the Box Experience. This may seem like a lot of passes, but you can see that there are only 3 passes that were configured in the answer file. If I expand down into the Windows PE section, you can see that low-level options such as how to configure the hard disk can be configured. You can configure items such as the size of the partition you want to create and the type of partition. If I expand Image and down to Install To, you can decide which partition you want to install to. In the User Data section, you can configure the product key that will be used. If you have an enterprise key, this is a great feature as it saves you from entering the product key on every computer on which you install the image. If you go down to the Specialized pass, you can configure items such as Auto Logon. If you want the computer to log in automatically using a username and password, you can configure this here. This is all well and good if the settings you want were included in the sample file. However, not every setting you want may be there. If I now go to the Components section of the image file, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of settings you can add. For example, if I select the fax service, I can add it. Notice that these settings can only be added to pass 4. A lot of settings can be added to multiple passes. Once added, I can now see fax-related items in the answer file. You could spend hours going through the settings and adding them to your answer file. On an enterprise network, you are most likely going to configure your computers using group policy. When deciding which settings to add to the answer file, I would ask myself this question first. Which settings can I configure using group policy? If they can be configured using group policy, I would not worry about setting these settings in the answer file, since group policy can be changed at any time. If I go down to the out-of-box experience, I can configure things such as the default administrator account and the password. One word of warning. When adding passwords to answer files, the answer file is in XML format, which is a text file. Anyone with access to this file can read the file with programs such as Notepad and thus get access to any passwords contained in this file. Once I have finished making changes, I need to select the option Save Answer File. Otherwise, it will attempt to save over the sample file. For the file name, I will select auto-unattend.xml. This is the default name that Windows 7 will look for when setup starts. Down at the bottom of the screen, you will see a warning stating that one of the components does not have any settings and will not be saved in the answer file. This is the fax component I added. I did not configure it, so this is to be expected. If you want to check your answer file for mistakes, you can do this at any time by selecting the option Validate Answer File from the Tools menu. It is best to make sure you check your answer file before you use it to make sure that there are no errors, otherwise your answer file may not even be read. Once you have created your answer file, you can add it to the root of your USB drive or to the root of your DVD. It will be read and used automatically by setup. Answer files are only one way to customize your Windows 7 install. If you want to completely customize Windows, an answer file is probably not the best way to go about it. Answer files are good for providing a base system with the settings and features that you want. For more advanced customization, it is best to create a reference image, which is the topic of our next video.